I would like to thank the program for the promotion of self-help, for the invitation, as well as for the hospitality and the support it has given us by offering his premises for our activities. This premise. The initiative of Parents and Friends of Adolescents and Young Adults with Mental Disability and Autism constitutes as movement of citizens established in 2013 with more systematic activity as of March 2014 at the welcoming premises of the Program for the Promotion of Self-Help in Nakanya. This initiative was set up by a group of parents and was gradually supported by friends and volunteers with experience in communicating with people with various difficulties and diversities. Our group was motivated by and based on our shared belief in the fact that every person has a right, as well as a need, to participate actively in life on equal terms within the community, and thus satisfy his need and desire for communication, education, employment, and entertainment. We are opposed to any exclusion, discrimination, and marginalization against any person, and particularly those who do not meet with the stereotypical standards of normality. So, as you may know, we live in a country seriously lacking not only in social organization, but also in a state notion of supporting and integrating vulnerable and defenseless individuals. The prolonged economic crisis and the inhuman consequences of the austerity have weakened even further the already inadequate structures and the few state programs aimed at those that comprise a large part of the population. It is also significant to note the overall attitude towards disability as a state of exception that creates fertile ground for philanthropic and institutional activities, which nowadays tend to substitute the statutory obligation of every contemporary social state to protect and support its weakest members. Having this in mind, initially we tried to find parents who would like to organize themselves and work towards the setting up of a meeting place that would operate based in the following targets. So the first, constitute a permanent and steady meeting place of communication and entertainment for the children and their friends. Second, act as a meeting place for exchanging ideas and for solidarity for parents and sensitized friends, as well as for young scientists who wish to support this effort and at the same time gain valuable experience and have hands-on practice. The third, establish a cell of self-help that will be able to plan and support the integration, employment, and as far as possible, the self-management of young adults with such difficulties. The purpose of this movement is not to substitute structures or become one more employment center where experts will be teaching the young. We have many of them. On the contrary, we wish to avoid this model. Actually, we wish to bring the youngsters into contact with each other and with other young adults without their difficulties, who will decide for themselves what they will want to do and who will communicate freely on equal terms. With faith in the beneficial for the community idea and implementation of interaction, we addressed young people with sensitivity, knowledge, and some experience, mostly in welfare places such as the People with Special Needs Camp, which is in of the municipality of Kanya, the Samaritans of the Red Cross, and other social structures of solidarity. So our idea was that they should get to know our youngsters and form a group with sincere interest and enthusiasm, acting as coordinators, escorts, when taking part in social and recreational activities in the town. So this place was set up here. It has been operating for a year now with a young and their volunteer friends meeting every second Sunday here in this place. It is worth mentioning that though small and despite the restrictions that exist in voluntary schemes, and I think we are all aware of them, the group of volunteers functions constantly and responsibly and has a very good and warm communication with the young. It is a group of about four or five young people each time. The constitution and operation of the initiative was far from easy. It took quite a long time, about 2 years, several meetings, and a lot of effort in order to tackle procedural issues and develop trust and cooperation between the members. Although some parents have known each other for many years, they had never collaborated with one another because, as it often happens here in Greece, they were either passive members of some parent associations or they were trying to deal with a child's problem alone and often competitively. Lack of space, in addition to limited financial resources, was a serious obstacle. So as disappointment and withdrawal had already started to set in, a turning point to the course of the initiative was when a friend suggested that we address the program for the promotion of self-help. And thanks to the people here, the reply from the program and to Figo Zafiridis, who I don't know, was prompt and positive. Besides the disposal of the premises on days and times they were not in use on Sundays, we asked the coordinators to inform us about the self-help, which gave the group a different, much-needed perspective, and more importantly, it gave a fresh impetus to the dynamic of the parents and friends volunteer groups. Thus, the premises could be used as a meeting place for discussion, communication, and entertainment for the parents, and at the same time, or independently, for the youngsters and the friends as a familiar place, which they called to steki, which in Greek means the place where friends regularly meet. The security and support offered by the program is particularly significant, mostly due to the possibility of advisory and organizational support whenever needed. So we are grateful as this steady possibility enables us to plan the next step of the initiative, in which we hope to be able to collaborate with the program as well as with interested citizens and groups. This step is dealing with a major problem of employment and integration in the work market of those individuals that belong to sensitive groups on terms that will correspond to their skills and that will allow them to live independently with dignity, enjoying their rights and opportunities as equal citizens within the society. We know that it will take a lot of effort and a long struggle, but we do hope to be able to move forward. Thank you.
Before questions, I would like to make a small comment. Pavlina is not either a representative of a sincere American in Greece, because he has a lot of experience in struggles and associations, etc. She's the vice president of the Greek Association for Asperger's Syndrome. So she has a lot of experience all these years regarding the positives and the negative aspects of all these things. And I just want to say that it's all of us have the experience that the initiators of such efforts should have a broader view of things in order that the effort to go on. So, questions, comments for Pavlina? Yuri.
Well, first of all, I would like to know how many people you're talking about, how many parents, how many dancers?
In the moment, we are about, the group of the parents is about 15 people. More mothers than fathers, so it's like that. But there are also some fathers taking members of the initiative. So, and the members of the group of the youngsters and their friends, it's also about 15 persons. We have asked for many more people, but in the moment we try to establish something steady so that we can later on go with more people in that what we are planning to do.
My second question, if I may continue. I did understand well that you avoided diagnostic terms, but nevertheless, just to help me, could you give me some diagnostic labels of the youngsters? You talked about disabilities. What exactly does that mean?
Most of them have mental disabilities in several, not only one kind, several kinds. Some of them have also disabilities, moving disabilities, mm-hmm. but not, they are not on rolling chairs. Mm-hmm. We could not, we tried to begin with youngsters, with young people who can be, they can be a kind of, they have an independence of moving, of the moving, because we couldn't pay, first of all, we couldn't have professionals that we could pay to escort them. So we have no, just the volunteers who they can take a responsibility, but not a very big responsibility. This is the one, and the other is that we are just an initiative. We're not a, something like an association or something like that. So we don't have the legal. We're not a legal, but that is so. And the other disability is coming from the audience spectrum, you know. And in this also field, we have young people with autism, but functional autism, not Asperger. You know the Asperger syndrome. There are few of them, and autism. They can also communicate a bit. That is. And the most of the young people, they are already in institutions during the week. Schools or so education centers, the few we have here. This is.
And as computers become more available to people, I think you know, online support groups are a real possibility for people who can't, are not easily mobile, but also fabulous for autistic.
Mm-hmm. Sure. Yes, but not if we don't need them, we don't have computers yet so that the youngs can work in some. I know there are special problems there, but we don't have them yet. Because the point for us was first to form these groups that could regularly meet and function and work in this direction of communication and entertainment also, because this is the problem. Most of the young people, and there are many also in this town, in this small town, they are in their homes with parents, they don't have a social life, and that is what we wanted at first to do.
Pavlina, would you like to tell us about the next step, some things? Because I have told the first day that we try to evolve here in Greece, not to evolve, to use the ideas and the philosophy of self-help and mutual aid in other things regarding the integration.
I can say
just the idea.
Which we research now. So we now we are also in discussion with some other people who have already the experience. We are researching the possibility to establish a social cooperative enterprise. And this enterprise will offer employment and training to people coming from vulnerable social groups. This enterprise, we have the example of a very successful enterprise in Athens, which is a cafe. It is established in a district of Athens, where there are many cafes and there are many new young people that come passing every day, and they have established there a cafe with also many.
Activities
in the field of culture and also training groups and something like that. And we are now in discussion with them to see if we could also do something like that in here in Kanya. And that's why we would like to cooperate with the program, which has the same problem of integrating people from such groups, and but also citizens who are interested in working in such enterprise. This is the next step we're planning. Of course, it has a lot of bureaucracy and much work to do before taking the permission
to find you, but we will try. Can you find information about the cafe in Athens online?
Yes, you can.
The name.
It is called
Mirdilov.
Exactly.
This is Mirdilov. M-Y.
Yeah.
R-T-I. Double L, I think.
Yes, double L.
Thank you.
They have a very, very good site.
Yes.
What is this? Without the S. Mirtilo Cafe. Is it also
It's the berry, the violet berry.
Yeah. Yes, the frog.
Just an association to this fantasy project vision. There are a couple of projects of that kind in Germany, where I'm from, in the field of cafe, hotel, restaurant. Even in my place, which is not so big one, we have, and they call it training restaurant, and it's open. I mean, it's written in the, on the first page of the manual. That's people with special needs working here. So not everything is perfect, but there are some people in town like me who love to go there because the food must be at least acceptable, right? If it's bad, it doesn't work. But the benefit is that I feel if I have my dinner there, it's first of all, it's good food. Secondly, it gives me credit points in heaven. So what I want to say, don't hide that. Make it public. And for example, in such a place where tourists from Central Europe and Northern Europe arrive, they are very eager to go to such a place and have their coffee there.
Yes, we're having this in mind. We're trying to specialize exactly our activities in this direction, because Panya is a touristic place, and also there are quite of sensitized people visiting Panya. So yes, and if you have the site of this restaurant, you know how the name.
Yeah, I can give you later.
Yes, okay.
Yes, and the last thing that I'm very. Fond of this effort is Pavlina. Pavlina is another parent of the here as well. They say Pavlina proposed us to combine the youngsters of the association and some former drug addicts into this effort. Because cafes or social cooperatives with people from a spectrum of problems is something that it's not common, but we have seen it here in Greece. But the combination of former drug addicts with people from the older spectrum, it would be, if we could succeed something like that, I would be very proud of it. And we are starting some common activities right now with our people, the people and the youngsters, in order to make the facilitation.
The interaction is always, I think, gives points to these social groups and experience in the direction of open-minded in just sensitizing people in everything which is different from what they know. This is a challenge.
Maybe at some point, I know that many people with illnesses and disabilities are pulled by animals, horses,
yes.
or dogs, and I can't help but think of so many of the dogs on the creek here. You know, who may need to be vaccinated, whatever. So it just makes me think there's a need, the dogs, and a need of the people. So just in the back of your mind.
Yeah,
yeah.
That's a good idea, but I don't know how we can raise it.
It's culturally different.
Yeah.
Dog culture.
It's the minimum you said.